Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. Welcome to episode 4 of my Minecraft Regrowth playthrough. You find me here with my back companion, upgrading my pickaxes. I did some work with the pickaxes and felt that, you know, the durability is just a bit low, so I'm upgrading with Pokefinium tool rods here, and if we look at the recipe for that, it's just molten pokefinium, which is cobalt, iron, and blood. And, you know, for the total liquid you put in, you get about half that much out, but twice as much in terms of ingots. Or, yeah. So. Let's get that done. I've also made this one with silk touch, and because it's useful to have a silk touch, so I've now got a fortune and a silk touch pickaxe. I've also got here some ingredients for spawn eggs, so I'll do those in a bit. In fact, let's go and start one off now. Finishing off from where we were last episode. We'll make a skeleton spawn egg and carry on with it. So, skull, bone block, bow arrow, spawn villager. Right, okay, so. One spawn villager. Bow arrow, and. Three, four. There we go. So we'll let that go. While that's going, I'll show you something else I worked on. I went and cleared out the treasure building. Just dismantled all of it. Which left me with a lot of breached, blown bricks here. So I've changed my wall. Came up with this little design. It's decorative and functional. It's got an overhang so spiders can't climb up and I can't jump up here. Even in the gaps it's actually quite hard. I can't do it first time obviously. And you've got gaps to shoot arrows through. And here I've got this walkway so I can pop over. And also, you know, stand and shoot through this gap here. So I've had a lot of blocks, and I've made the wall all the way around, as you can just about see there. So that's good. Is this almost ready? No. I'll show you the doorway actually, because it's just some walls here and pumpkins on for sort of lights at the corners and pillars. And I'm using a gate here, a fence gate, because I like that it gives you something you can shoot through and see through, but also that nothing can get over it. So, that is now ready. I need my wand. There's my wand. And I also need some redstone for the spawn egg. I'm going to do, so we'll just do a couple of those. Missed. So that is the skeleton spawn egg. And if I look at the quest book. Oh, apparently I have two unclaimed rewards now, so what are they? This is the life of the world, I think, where the skeleton spawn egg is. Go back. So let's claim that. And what's next? We've got witches, hobgoblins, spiders. I can make that one. Let's get the next thing. So next, I think. I want Hobgoblin, is it? Let's try the hobgoblin. Yeah, stone. One of those. And 1, 2, 3. Okay. So while that's going up, let's show you something else I was going to do. I found another option, or just worked out another option for the bees and the silk for the quest to make the apiarist gear, and that is the acclimatizer. So now I'm trying to acclimatize a bee. And the book, actually, if we look at the quest book here, trying to remember where it is. Not there. It's actually, I think it's in the quest. Where is it? This, no. It's in one of these. The quest for the actual encoding of the world. There it is. Right, the one that actually tells you how to make an acclimatizer, not the isolate. There it is, the acclimatizer actually tells you how to use it as well, so that's very useful. And so I've got a tropical. Wait a minute. Hang on a minute. That gave me silky combs, or supposedly gave me silky combs, but I don't remember having that many. Maybe that's all the silk I got out of it was just enough to make the pieces I currently have. So yeah, if we get a tropical queen, we can. I've got a few more tropical queens, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to these are going to be a struggle. Use lots of sand, use lots of power. Fortunately, I've just finished making some charcoal because I needed torches, so I can trigger the power and we'll get that started as well. And while I'm here, I might as well make some more sand, so I've got that ready to go. So that will start giving me some steam soon, and then we can get that all ready. I've already filled up my drawer of XP. Anyway, let's put that stack back. Slight drawback to having the B button as the hotbar swap is that the B button is also for the baubles. So if I do, let's see if that's actually ready. Go back to the life of the world. Doesn't recognize it as being there because it's in the other imagery. There it is. And that's now completed, so we'll clean that one. Right. So what else have we got? Last villager, I think, was the witch we can do. So that's the sugar of the hand, splash potion, poison. Which is probably just a potion of poison. Gunpowder, nice and easy. So, drop that over there. And 1, 2, 3, 4. There we go. Right. So that's going away now. Now. Let me look at what else we can do here. You might see here I've got my thermometer out, and that's because I found a fix for the issue I was having with Thorncraft on the Thorncraft wiki, which I'll put a link to. There is a fact page, and in there it's actually a fairly, I guess it's a fairly common sort of bug where it kind of doesn't recognize you anymore or something. But the only way to fix it, unfortunately, is to revert to a backup of your Thorncraft file. Fortunately, I had one, so I did replace the Thorncraft files I had. Unfortunately, that meant I was right back at the start, so I could probably have just deleted the Thorncraft file. And but since I'm back at the start, I'm now scanning everything, and everything's scanning. The mod pack actually includes something, and I'm not sure what it is, but it's something to allow you to scan within the inventory, which is very, very handy. I've played other sort of mod packs, and I think the other sort of, if you don't have that mod involved, the second most useful is probably Draconic Evolution, which allows you to place items anywhere. That is almost as handy. Right, so that was the witch. So I can now do the witch. Clear that one. It gives me two witches. And then I can spawn coven witches. Now, the spawn coven witches is a bit trickier. Because it requires koboldite. It also requires a hobgoblin spawn and a witch spawning. But the koboldite is the tricky bit. So, actually, while I'm here, I'm going to do the next thing I had. Get the spider going. Okay, so I need to find somewhere for the kobold. I happen to have a nice little fenced-in area over here. That'll stop him getting attacked and other things. So, sorry, not a kobold, a hobgoblin. There he is. Hi, buddy. Oh. I think you get koboldite from these guys, but he doesn't seem to want to trade with me, so I'm gonna have to look into that, I think. How do we get koboldite? There's no recipe as such, so I guess I'm gonna have to look at the Witchery wiki or something to find out how to get koboldite. This is getting on. And I think after I've done that, I can use this to make the silverfish for the last bit on that side, and that will just leave me actually. Ah, four knights, so let's make one of those. Now that requires a skeleton and a zombie. Fawnsteed. Is there a recipe for that one? No. And a wither skull candle. That's not too much of a problem. I think I've got some wither skull still, maybe. Block of flesh, another bone block, and an iron sword. Couple bits of iron. Don't have any sticks. As you can see, here's all the bleached bone I got. This is just from one building that is. So yeah. So there. Must have some somewhere. Block of flesh. Right, how to make a candle. Gravestone candle. Yeah, easy. While I wait for that, the other thing I was looking at is more quests, different quests here. What's this other one actually? I've got another one apparently. I'm gonna open that. Oh, chalk. Ah, I haven't done that bit. Okay, so I can do a charged June stone. I need to do that anyway, because there was something I was going to do. Spectral familiar. Spectral dust. I've got to kill a familiar? I don't really want to do that, but that means I have to get a familiar in the first place. So, the first thing I need to do is get that now. Life of the world? No. How the world grows. Yes, here we go. Toads. You can use toads as a familiar. So I've set up a little area to do that. And I've got some bits ready. That's that here. I need a charged attuned stone. So if we look here in the Circle Magic book, the charging of the attuned stone is somewhere around here. Yeah. Attuned stone, glowstone dust, redstone, wood ash, good climb. Now you might have spotted upstairs, or, well, I say upstairs. here my little platform. I hope it's in range. The altar's just down there, and with the athame here, you can see the dagger increases the range of the altar, so but only for the actual things like this, the circles and the other things actually use the power from the altar. So I don't think it really matters, but I'm going to put these graspers down here just because otherwise my magnet will just pick up any items I try and drop on the floor. And I think that's ready. I need a tuned stone. And there we go. One charge of tuned stone. So there's a different quest which tells you how to make an attuned stone, but so that's the attuned stone, which means I can get that as well. There we go. And this gives me lots of stuff. Oh, that's summoning a demon, isn't it? Yes. I need to get some refined evil. Wonderful. Hang on a minute, that looked like Arthana, but it seems to have an enchantment on it, so that's going to be going good. Let's claim this. I get two more attuned stones. Excellent. These are really useful. So, they can go there. I'll just pick that up. Get these graspers down, and we're doing to the next bit. So I've made a little area over here for the toads. I'm hoping this fence is high enough. And to make the toads, I need stuff. What do I need? I think the quest book actually tells you, which is really useful. So, where were we? How the world grows. This is the detection task for graspers. So instead, slimes, full graspers. So I've got these in place. Grasper, 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 grasper. I need instead slimes. But the spawning is probably finished. Yes, there it is. So that's good. We'll do that. And I'll just hand that one in. Going a bit all over the place here. Life for the world, there it is. Clean that up. And then we can do the last. Which is... So we want the zombie, skeleton, iron sword. That. That. And flesh. And then... And I've done something wrong. Skeleton zombie with a skull, block of flesh, iron sword. Oh, five. Right. So that's all good. Let's go and get the slimes. To actually catch these, I had to get a spawn slime egg and then kill it into the, so break into the four smaller ones and then put the crit snares down. I did that in the area where the hobgoblin's now residing. So I'm leaving other stuff around. I need other bits for this. The one thing that's not quite good, I mean obviously this quest book tells you how to do this, but it's quite a complicated rite, but it's not actually mentioned in any of the books from Witcher itself, so far as I've seen anyway. Right, and an ocelot. And one charged stone, and an ocelot, and a spider web, which I think I have up there. Let's put these away. I'll double check. Take that one just in case. Oh yeah, I do have. Okay. So the spider web goes here. So that goes there. Should have put these in there, I think. And how do I start the right? Need the mutating branch, don't I? Oh, hang on. Yeah, there it is, mutating sprig. That's it. So, trigger this by. There we are. And there's the toads. Excellent. And. Okay, they can't actually get out of there. Don't want them drowning, so just how am I gonna do? Jump? Can it jump over the fence? Because that would be bad. Good. Okay. Great. So I've got some toads now. There's another quest for owls, but I think that's slightly trickier. Is this ready? It is ready. Excellent. And that's the fallen knight. Just put that away. So I'm ready for owls, I think. But I need to get some other stuff. It uses up the attuned, the charged stone, so yeah. Let's put this way and this way. And let's see what else we can do. So we'll hand in those quests now. Oh, I have to kill one. I have to kill a toad. Hang on. Your trouble. I've got a toad frog. Which is really useful. It does actually tell me, I think, in the book how to breed them as well. Tame toads bred using rotten flesh. Excellent. So I can actually just grab my big stack of rotten flesh that I have and then claim rewards. So I get three more toad frog. Great. Another protection puppet. a poppet protection poppet, which is not gonna be useful, I think, because I'm single player here, so we'll leave that. And there was one other quest, did, which is... excuse me. Okay, so that last spawn egg, claim reward. So that just leaves me with the Coven Witches. And so I'm going to need to find out how to get the Koboldite ingot. If anyone knows, feel free to leave a comment. But I'm just going to put this stuff away, and I think that is about, that's about it for today. We'll have a quick look at the bee and see how he's doing. This does not seem to be doing anything. Both one. Not sure if it's going to make a difference. Sometimes, apparently, I'm going to regret this. You know what, actually? Let's put that in. See if that's going to use it. Doesn't say anything. No acclimatizing. What do you mean, no acclimatizing items? What do you call? Has it used? Oh, it used the sand. Wait, what? Ah, that was a bit of a bug then. Okay, so where's my? Have I got any more sand? It went through all the sand and didn't really do anything. So. Right, okay. Let's see what that does. That's says it will go one both directions, so that's not bad, but I don't think it's good enough just yet. Get another stack of sand. Yeah, and and I'm now completely out of sand. So I may have to go and get some more sand, but that's good. We'll see how that does. And let's make some more sand as well. Temperature's dropped too far, yeah. Okay. So we can switch off. I'll switch that over to the other thing. But I think that will do us for today. Thank you all for watching, and farewell and good night.